What's up, guys? Thank you so much for tuning in today's video. Today we have something special. It's nothing crazy special, but it's a surprise. We're getting something before harvest for this year's harvest, and my dad and I are on our way to go get it, or we're about ready to go on our way to go get it. Any point during this video you like it, give it a thumbs up. It really helps me out, supports me a lot, and pushes my content out further for more farmers like you to see it. If you like this farm and what it's about, subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell icon to get notified every time I post a video. With that being said, guys, I'm going to take you along this journey. Firth, Brent, Kill Brothers, and Parker. They make all those brands. Oh, fuck.
It's like a kid in the candy store.
I know.
Damn, there's a lot.
Somebody better get to selling.
We just got back from our 3-hour ride home. We had to go about like 40 miles an hour to get back, but we're dropping it off at our John Deere dealer. They're gonna make sure everything's good on it and greased up and all that good stuff before we go and take it out onto our farm, and then we're gonna come back and get it, and we'll tell you everything about it and why we got it and why we got another one. All right, guys, it's been a couple days since our journey to go get the wagon. We had to take it to John Deere, as you guys know, and we had to get it all greased up, and they had to look at it, make sure everything was good on it so we could use it for harvest this year. And they finally called us back. It's been about like 3 days, 4 days, and so now we're gonna head in there, grab it, and then we're gonna bring it back, and we're gonna finally explain to you guys why we got it and all that, and what everything that you guys want to know about it, whatever. It's not like, it's nothing crazy, it's just a wagon, but still it's real nice, and it's good, nice to have, because our old wagons, not very good.
Well, we just brought this one home today. So this is a 657. It's like the other one we've got. We got that one, I don't know, 3 years ago. And these wagons, they're kind of like being Amish. It's okay as long as you don't know any better, because all our other wagons are old Parkers and they hold about 300 bushel, and the gear on them's not very good. And we ended up buying our other Brent out of necessity because our old dryer didn't keep up, and we were having a hard time keeping up when our neighbor that combines for us runs an 8-row head, and trying to keep the corn away from an 8-row head with 4 300 bushel wagons doesn't work very well. So we bought one, and then once you buy one and you realize how nice they are and how nice they pull and how nice it is to be able to haul that much corn in one shot, you kind of get kind of growly about your old wagons, and then you start scheming that, boy, we need to get another one. And it got easier because two of the Parkers we got, the gear on them is not very good and the tires are getting bad. So this year we decided before we start another harvest that we were going to get another one of these and then get rid of two of our old ones. And so yeah, we just picked this up, and we're gonna try to do beans this afternoon. It's getting less great by the minute because it was nice and sunny, and now it's getting cloudy, and hopefully they don't toughen up. The wind's going good, so with any luck we'll be able to run late tonight. Yeah, and the other problem that you get into as combines, when we quit combining our own stuff, our last combine that we had was a classy Massey 850, which was fine. But our neighbor runs a 9570, and it's so hard to even fill those wagons without running them over. He's pretty good, he can do it, but I can't do it. I'd run them over. And so this is a lot taller, and for the equipment that, for the harvest equipment that we're using, these are just a lot better.
What also we're gonna do today is we're gonna start harvesting, which is awesome. I'm excited. It's just like when I was playing football in high school. It gives me that same excitement, gives me that same joy of like when you've been training all summer and you finally get to, comes fall time and get to play. And I feel that's the same way as a farmer. just for harvest. So I'm excited for that. We're gonna go work. We're gonna start on beans because there's a field of beans that are ready, and our corn is still. The ground's too wet, and the moisture is not all the way where we want it to be. So we are going to wait on that, and after we pick these beans, see where we're at, and if it's good, we're gonna move into corn, and then come back and do the rest of the beans later. So yeah, that's the plan. All right, folks. So it's around 3 o'clock. One thing that I haven't really explained to you guys, and the reason I haven't explained to you is because it really hasn't came up, but we have a friend of ours custom combine for us because we don't have a combine. Like my dad said, the last combine we had was a long, long time ago. He does a real, real, real nice job. So we've just been waiting on him. He has his own ground that he's doing right now, and then he's gonna come over here and we're gonna run it for a long time. Hopefully he can run it through the night, or run it tonight, or whenever he wants to stop. So that's the plan right now, but we're gonna clean the filters on this tractor, and we're gonna go fill it up with some fuel, and then wait for him to get here, and we'll get going. All right, so now we got her filled up. I think we're gonna clean out the filters. So I'm gonna head back over to the machine shed, and we're gonna get the air compressor out and spray off the filters. And then hopefully he'll be here and we can get going, because I'm jonesing to get going. A lot has happened in the last couple days. So as you guys saw, we started harvest. There was a 90 acre field that we started harvest on in beans instead of corn, because the beans were ready and the corn was too moist, so we waited. That night, auger broke down. We couldn't load any of the beans that we were getting into the bin, so we had to back in all the wagons that we had into our machine shed and close it up because it was gonna rain that night. And literally right after we put them all in the machine shed, it started raining. I didn't record any of that because my camera batteries were dead. They died, and I didn't have time to run home into town and grab my other set, or I didn't have time to charge it. So I didn't record any of that. But if you saw my Instagram story, you saw that I kind of showed you whatever. What's up with that? Anyway, fast forward, we waited a couple days because it rained and we didn't want to get stuck or any of that. So we came back today and we are going to finish up the beans. We have another patch of beans that we're going to do, about a 20 acre patch of beans, and I don't know if they're mature enough to be ready to go. But if they are, we're just going to keep the bean head on and go get those. And if they're not, we're going to switch up, put the corn head on, and go straight to corn tomorrow. So I'll keep you updated on what we do. So now we actually didn't get all these beans picked because these beans aren't quite ready yet. They're a different hybrid, and so they're not ready. They're not mature enough. So we're gonna head over there and see if those are ready. And if they are, we're gonna pick that 20 acre patch tonight, and then probably switch up to corn tomorrow and start picking corn tomorrow, and then we'll come back and get this later. So yeah.
Oh. inside me, leave me on my way. Oh Lord, live inside me, leave me on my way, lead me home, lead me home. Oh Lord, in the darkness, lead me on my way. Oh Lord, in the darkness, lead me on my way, lead me home, lead me home.
So the combine broke down, a bolt and a washer fell out of the damn, I don't know, I'm not an expert on combines, but we're missing a bolt and a washer where it needs to be. It could have fell out a long time ago, could have fell out, you know, an hour ago, could have fell out 20 minutes ago, but it's not in the area that we have been looking around for. Pretty much on that, we're gonna have to go get a new bolt and washer and install it for the table to run again, because there's probably not a good chance we're going to find it. We heard it squealing while we were unloading the beans onto the wagon. It just started squealing, so we shut it off, looked, and we're missing it. So, shit happens, but we're going to get it fixed, and hopefully we'll be ready to pick corn for tomorrow. I think we'll be done for the night, though. If we can't find this, we'll get it replaced. So I'll keep you updated and let you know if we're gonna be done or not. We lost it. We can't find it. We're gonna have to get a new one, replace it. And they'll be back here to combine the rest of these beans tomorrow, I think. We're gonna finish up these beans tomorrow, and I think we might switch over to corn tomorrow as well. Hopefully we can get it all replaced for tomorrow. So right now I'm going to unload this wagon. It's almost all the way full. He had probably a bushel left on that combine, but it's not a big deal. So I'm gonna unload this and probably put it in the machine shed and call it a night. It really sucks that we had to stop. I wish we could have got this 20-acre patch of beans done. That way we can just go straight into corn tomorrow, but shit happens. So this is gonna be the last load of the night. Not a whole lot we can do about what happened. Shit happens like that all the time. So just gonna get this loaded, park it in the machine shed, and call it good. With that being said, guys, thank you so much for tuning in today's video. I know it was a long one. I know it was a stretched out for a couple days. I'm gonna have multiple parts of harvest, but I think this is a good stopping point for part one. So thank you so much for tuning in. Please give it a thumbs up. It really, really helps me out and pushes my content out further for more farmers like you to see it. Or if you're not a farmer and you just like farming content, for more people like you to see it. If you like what this farm's about and you like who I am as a person and my, you know, family farm, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon to get notified every time I post a video, and I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Peace.